everyone. Again, I'm Oberon Titania, and we are in Planet Zoo, and we are going through the career mode scenarios. And last time, we did the first one, the Goodwin Zoo. So this time, we're going over the second one, which is the Madagascar Simian Conservation Project, which I'm really excited for because I do like the layout of this scenario. It is really fun. So let's go ahead and get started here. There we go, the Madagascar Simian Conservation Project. Apprenticeship. Oh, Madagascar. I want to go there one day. The Madagascan Simian Conservation Zoo is the culmination of Bernard Goodwin's work in the region, specializing in simian breed and release programs. Simian, if you look it up, is apes, orangutans, lemurs, those types of animals, and release programs, as well as championing and highlighting the diverse species of apes and monkeys. But never one to be complacent, Bernard now wants to see what you can do, or I can do, in this most promising of locations. So let's start it up. And just as a side note, as we're starting this, I want to get through the tutorial part as fast as possible. Then when we get to the building part, I'm going to see if I can do any fast forwards or things like that, so that I don't drag this over an hour. I want to make this between 30 and 40 minutes long. I don't know if I'll succeed, but I definitely do not want it to be longer than an hour. So let's cross our fingers and see what we get. Isn't this beautiful?
Welcome to Madagascar. It's quite the change of scenery from old England, huh?
Oh, yes, it sure
apart
is.
Apart from the weather, I suppose. They don't call these places rainforest for nothing.
Wow, so nice.
The zoo you'll be working in is an ape sanctuary, where we're doing vitally important conservation work. Not
Zola.
Just for apes, but for all
Welcome.
Kinds of species.
What do you think of Madagascar, then?
Hi, Nancy.
It's warm for my taste, to be honest. Anyway, this is Bernie's primate sanctuary. It's not just primates, though. We've got all sorts of animals. So why don't
okay.
we go and have a look at some of them, eh?
We'll I'm
start
ready.
By taking a look at the red-ruffed lemurs. They're the ones that look like they should be in a Shakespeare play. Come on, let's head over to them.
Okay. So remember the last time I was telling you tips and tricks of how to navigate? Well, here's one. Instead of moving my mouse over there to go to it, I'm just going to go over here to the marker button and click on it. Then my arrow key to go in.
Found in the rainforests of Madagascar. That's in northeast Madagascar. They can actually live anywhere from 15 up to 25 years. Fancy that, eh? Okay, when you're ready, let's go find our Bornean orangutans.
Alright. So I'm going to use E to go up, and then I'm using my mouse to circle, and there we go. Now I don't have a marker for this one. I'm using the arrow keys, and then Q to go down.
The Bornean orangutan is such a marvelous creature. They're always a big favorite at any zoo they feature in, and they're also
Ooh.
The biggest tree-dwelling animal on the planet. Assuming you don't count any lions that got stuck up one.
Ha ha ha.
Why don't you take a better look at them? Open up their information panel and go into the animal camera.
Animal camera?
Aren't they
That's where
just
I
incredible.
Was, Nancy.
When you're ready,
yes,
let's
they
go
are
and
incredible.
Look, see at some of our beautiful
Ooh, look
bonobos.
At that in the sun.
They're quite the characters.
Okay. So I'm using the E button to go up, the mouse to circle, and arrow to get back in there. Okay, so Q to go down, to go up, and boom!
Oh dear! It looks like we've arrived just in time.
Oh, look,
one
yep,
of the
right there.
Barriers has collapsed.
Oh no!
Don't you know it? One of the bonobos has made a run for it. We'll need to catch them. But before
All right.
we do, we should box up the other bonobos
oh,
to stop them
okay,
escaping.
Let's box them up. Let's box
Select
up.
The habitat boundary to
Select.
Bring up the habitat information panel.
Okay, then go over here to
Good,
that pink button.
Open the
animals.
Tab.
And right here where it says,
and click on
box
all
animals.
To box up the remaining bonobos.
There we go, Nancy, did that.
Now, we'll need a vet to recapture that escaped bonobo. But
oh,
it seems our last one left to do some research in the wild. Not an ideal situation. So, we'll need to hire a replacement, sharpish.
All right.
Go into the zoo section and then into the staff management area.
Zoo? Staff?
You can find all of your staff in here. But there's no time to go looking at their particulars at the moment. Hire a vet.
I hired a vet. Now right click to deselect.
Okay, that's a relief. So while the vet deals with our bonobo friend, let's go fix up their habitat so they can't escape again. Head back over there.
Okay. Locate the highlighted area. In that case, I'm just going to click on that.
As you can see, the barrier's collapsed. Someone's taken their eye off the ball, obviously. Let's get this one replaced. Select the barrier, and then we'll edit it.
All right,
delete
the barrier selected.
Barrier and replace it with a brand new one.
Edit barrier. Not that one. I want this one, and I'm just going to say delete. And as soon as I do delete, a new barrier pops up, and we can just join it.
Good.
There
now
we go.
Now we've done that, we need to make sure to add climb-proof
barriers. It's missing that right there.
That way the bonobos won't be able
That's
to climb
the climb-proof
out.
Stuff.
Just make sure you've got the correct piece of barrier selected.
I select that. Come over here.
So go into the options section and select which
side
the climb-proof barrier needs to go on.
The left. It's normally where you're looking.
We're more worried about bonobos climbing out than guests climbing in.
Yeah. Sometimes you don't know what to do.
And I think it's high time we unbox those bonobos, wouldn't you say?
Oh, you think so?
The poor mites will get sad if we leave them in there for too long.
All right, so I clicked on the barrier again.
Select the habitat barrier to bring up the habitat information panel again.
And here's the unbox all animals right next to the box all animals.
Unbox all animals to let them out.
There you go, Nancy.
I expect some of
them
bursting for the toilet.
Okay.
So, it turns out that as well as the old vet leaving, the zoo's mechanics did too.
Oh.
We'll need to hire a couple of new ones so we can help stop any more breakouts.
Okay.
You see, mechanics do all sorts of helpful things around the zoo, but
Where's
one of their most important jobs
area?
Is taking care of the habitat barriers. Without mechanics around to repair them, the barriers will crack and rumble.
Oh, we don't like that.
And before you know it, we'll be overrun with escaped
animals.
Okay, so
we go over here to zoo management.
Go into the zoo section,
and
then to the staff management area.
Staff is still up, and here's the
mechanics. And then click on a path to place them in the zoo.
Okay.
And then
click
on the path again to hire a second mechanic.
So we just got two mechanics.
You don't have to go back into staff management if you're hiring lots of the same type of staff member.
Oh, that's nice to know.
Gosh,
okay.
We have been busy, haven't we?
We sure have, Nancy.
I'm off for a cuppa. Oh, I think Bernie wants a word with you.
Oh, okay. Hi, Bernie. Where are you?
Oh,
oh, there you are.
I hear you had a bit of an issue with an escaped bonobo.
Why, this thing's just way ahead.
You dealt with it swiftly, and more importantly, without the animal stealing someone's clothes, putting them on, and then walking out of the front gate.
It would be hard for them to do that.
You've probably noticed that there's already a building where I want you to build the research center. Don't
yes,
worry.
Thank you, Nancy.
The building that's currently there is actually a hollow shell.
Okay.
So we're able to place our new building
inside a research center.
If you select the research center placement and then hover over the shell, you'll see that it asks if you want to add the research center to the existing building.
Okay. I'm going to go down a bit so I can get a better balance.
Click to add it to the building.
All right. See where the mouse says select group? Okay. Now that
automatically connects to the path when we place it.
Nancy, thank you. She gets docked and I can't. Alright, now that she's gone, did you see that it said connect to the group already there? When I connected it to the group already there, it automatically snapped in and oriented itself according to what was there. Now, if you remember this object placement thing right there, it helps you know what to do. But remember, Z is our best friend. So if I click Z, it's going to rotate it. And if you notice, the building itself has a red hue to it. There's a red outline on it. That means I cannot set it down. But if I continue doing Z, it's now a blue hue. And I can click, and it's set down. Now I'm going to right-click to deselect.
Splendid work. Now that we have a brand spanking
new
research center, we can give our vet something to do. doing there.
Oh, by the way,
it's worth noting that the vets will only do research when they're not required to do any other jobs. That said, you can change what jobs a vet does via their information panel.
Okay.
But let's not worry about that just now.
So right now,
Nancy, we're just doing our research. Go into the zoo section and select vet research.
Zoo. Vet research right there.
You can see a list of all the animals present in your zoo. And also all the potential diseases that can occur.
Right, so there's the diseases down here.
The ring-tailed lemur to start their research.
The ring-tailed lemur. Right there.
Actually, thinking about it, I'm not sure we've got any education boards or speakers.
Well, in
by
that
the
case,
habitat.
Let's do E to go
let's
up.
Head over there and answer, so our guests can learn all about the furry little delight.
Can I just... Boom!
First off, let's pop down two education boards. Place them on the habitat barriers at a height that guests can see, pop them down on a stand.
Alright, so the education boards. Let's get a look at what we're doing, though. Excuse me, objectives. Alright, so looks like there's a stand right here and a stand right here. Nice. So we go over here to facilities. Down here, the immediate and education. We're going to grab an education board and pop it right there. Now we're going to go across over here and do the same thing right here.
Okay, now that they've been put into position,
right-click
we have to tell them what animal to display information about.
All right, so
select one of
I
the education boards to bring up its information panel.
And here's the information panel.
And from the drop-down list, select
ring-tailed lemur.
Although I'm sure that last part was obvious.
Well, possibly, Nancy, I could say the red-rumped lemur or the mantrill.
Make sure that said animal is close by. If it isn't, the guests will get confused and won't learn as much.
Oh, we want them to learn.
Okay, now
it says two education speakers here.
Speakers play
there are
audio
these guys
guests,
right here.
So they can
like
learn
soccer
while
balls
they look
or
the
football, depending on what area of the world you're in.
The laborious process of reading.
Oh,
one thing to bear in mind is that it's important not
if
to
you notice it just snaps
together.
Onto it.
If
just
you do, the guests won't be able to understand what's being said.
Now you can put these anywhere. You can put them
now
on the ground, you can put
the speakers to the ring-tailed lemurs.
But
like
they need to be
the
close
boards.
To the animal that they're educating people about. Or you'll get a warning. And their radius can't be too close
fantastic
to another either.
Oh, it's worth remembering that education boards and speakers both need power to work.
Okay.
They won't do much good without it.
Alright, I'll remember that.
It looks as though our vet has completed their research on lemurs.
Oh, see
we'll
right there.
Collect the results. We can do that by clicking
research
on the notification or by going back into the vet research area.
Okay.
Collect your research
report. I did, Nancy. Thank
just
you.
Vets will continue to research an animal.
You'll get pop-ups here about what's going
a research
on.
Level. I suppose when you're in the zone, you're in
you're
the zone.
I like being in the zone. All right.
Well, now that we've enriched the lives of our guests, let's enrich the lives of our ring-tailed lemurs.
All right, how are we going to do that, Nancy?
Like lemurs will have a climbing need. That means they have a requirement for a certain amount of climbing space.
So,
and you can fulfill that requirement by building up
a
climbing frame. Let's find out how much more climbing space our lemur friends
okay, so I went to the
shall
terrain
we?
Once
select
I clicked
one
on a
of them
lemur.
And bring up their information panel.
See, bring up their information
next,
panel.
Click
on
the
terrain
tab.
All right.
Now, as you can see, the lemurs need
they
quite
need
a lot
at least
46,
space. And
but
they only
happens,
have 21.
I've already got a climbing frame blueprint
okay, so let's
so
go
you can
to
either pop that down or build
right
one
here
yourself from scratch.
There we go, enrich
by
your
by
items
way,
right there.
Not always just climbing
and here,
that
climbing
you have to worry about. Other animals
so
might need a certain amount of water in their
it
habitat so they can go
and
for
let's
a swim.
Use the climbing frame she made
keep
for
us on
us
our toes.
Now, do you remember what I said about putting things in the ground? Well, I'm going to use the Z button right here. Let's see, where should we go with this? How about... Keep going in circles, stop it. Let's do that. Now, I want it in the ground, so So I'm going to do shift, and there we go. Outside placement area. There we go. Oh, probably because it's interfering with that. So if we do that. All right, what is outside placement area? That is not outside placement area. Now my game is giving me. There we go.
Oh, that's a great
timing
frame for them. They're
just
going to
absolutely
and it goes
love
up. It. Do you know
and the guests, because they're right on eye level.
Nicer food. But that's true of all of us, though, isn't it?
Well, it
you
all depends on the food.
Better quality food for animals through research.
Okay.
Luckily, we've already unlocked some for the lemurs.
We did. That's what that was
to make
for.
Sure they get served it from now on.
So,
let's bring up the habitat information panel by
so
selecting
click on
the
habitat. Information
Lovely.
Panel.
Now select the
animals tab.
There we go.
There. We're
As
talking
you can
about
see,
food,
we
right?
Can set the food quality
Tells
in
us
here.
The food right there.
Just click on the drop down menu.
It says
and
just
select
under
$1,000
per feed. Wow.
Grade 2 food
there
quality.
There we go.
My
We're set.
Already
How nice.
So,
okay.
A new climbing frame. Better food.
As Nancy
oh,
will say,
really
we're spoiling them rotten.
I think it's time we looked at one of the zoo's most important responsibilities.
Okay.
Releasing animals into the
Ooh,
wild.
We're rehabilitating
see,
them.
If an animal is ready, we can release them into the wild.
Let's do that.
What makes an animal a good candidate for release? Well, their
That's
age is an
a
important
good question.
Factor. I mean, we can't release an animal that's a juvenile, just as we can't release one that's gotten too old.
It needs to be just
they
right.
Need to be fertile. After all, the idea is to repopulate the wild, so the best candidates will have a high fertility gene.
Okay.
And together, the age and fertility of a candidate will determine how many conservation credits we'll be rewarded when we release them.
All right.
Now, conservation credits are vitally important. They're the lifeblood of your zoo.
You'll find
because
them down here. This is conservation credits.
Even more animals. And what's more, the animals you can adopt will be of a higher quality.
Oh, nice.
So, with that in mind, let's hop over to our orangutan habitat.
I'm right
yes,
there, Nancy.
I'd like you to find Agang, the Bornean orangutan in the habitat, and select him, please.
And
you
I found
the
game,
through each
and I selected
turn,
him.
Or select
now,
the habitat barrier.
This is what she means by high fertility.
And find him in the animal
okay?
list.
He's really good in that. And then there's this little thing that says release to the wild. So we're going to click on that, and he's going to look at that. That's how much credits we get for releasing him to the wild.
I know.
And he's gone.
Go, but he'll be happy out in the wild.
As long as he
and
survives the fights, he'll be happy.
Young, strong, and fertile. Excellent work there.
Alrighty.
Definitely got potential, you know.
Thank you, Nancy. Okay, so we just got that one.
I see,
Bernie, there
work.
You are again.
Although, it hardly seems like work when you're learning about something as adorable as a ring-tailed lemur. I imagine I'd have got much
fun,
better grades at
they?
School if there'd been less algebra and more aldebra.
Aldebra.
Tortoises.
Aldebra. Thank you, Bernie.
Now let's build a new exhibit in the gap that's been left. Just
okay.
add it to the building like we did with the research center earlier.
All
then
right,
pop it
we
into
can
the
do
gap.
That. So we go over here to facilities. There's the exhibit. So we just want a blank one. Now, see where it says select group 30 to add to? So if I select it, it hasn't placed it yet, but it oriented itself to that group. And now I'm going
to
say
Perfect.
Click.
The next
and then
thing
right
to
click
do is
to
adopt
deselect.
An exhibit animal to go in there. How about a Gila
right,
monster?
Exit out of the group.
Open
you
up
see
the
that orange bar?
And adopt
that
them.
Means you're in a building zone, and you don't want a building zone right now. So we X out of there, and then we X out of there. Now we're going here to Gila monster, which is already highlighted for us. Nice! Okay, so we're going
to
adopt this
one.
Just
as we do with habitat animals, we need to send the Gila monster to the exhibit.
So send
click
to zoo.
Click on the exhibit to send it there.
And click. So, it thinks I want to add it to this one. I don't. So make sure it's blue. And then click.
When you send an animal to an exhibit, it'll automatically
and then X
be given
out
the correct
menu.
Setup. But that doesn't mean it's completely ready for them. So let's
All right,
finish it off.
Q and arrows.
We'll start by adding some enrichment items. Click on the exhibit
All
to bring
right.
up its information
so
panel.
So here's the enrichment right here.
Good.
I just like putting in there because I love how that looks.
Know by now, you can unlock more enrichment levels by having one of your vets do some
research. Research, yes.
Now we'll also need to set the temperature and humidity in
the exhibit. So this is the temperature right there.
These are vitally important for keeping our healer monster happy and comfortable. 35 to 42. Click on the climate tab.
We move this bar, it says it's 30 right now, we want 35 to 42, so
you can change both,
let's say 39,
the dials below.
And this one needs to be
sure
between 15 and 25, it's at 83, 15 to 25, so less humidity. There we go, now it's at 22 and it starts going down. And if we look over here, look at that, he's so happy now.
And the last thing we need to look at is setting up the different
windows.
So click on the Windows tab.
There we go.
There's also an exhibit education board. Pop them down near your exhibits.
Remember
to teach your guests
okay.
about them. Let's add one now.
All right, so this is just like the education boards. We're gonna go here to facilities, media devices. There's the education for the exhibits. Do Z and pop that right there. Then we click on it like so, bring down the bar,
lovely
say Gila Monster.
Now our guests can learn all about our venomous friend here.
Oh, they'll have
right,
so much fun.
Now, I've got a bit of a big job for you.
Okay,
I'm
ready.
To increase the number of species in the zoo.
Yes!
You'll probably want to adopt both habitat and exhibit animals to do so. Which will mean building plenty of new habitats and exhibits for them.
Okay.
Off you pop.
All right. Thanks,
I'll check
Nancy.
In with you when you're almost done.
All right. Nancy asked us to add some more species in here. So going over here to the objectives tab, we need to have at least 12 species in the zoo. It says right here that we have 9 currently. She also mentioned that we could add another exhibit animal, which will be great. So, let's see. Yep, right there. See, we have an empty exhibit space. It's already built, we just need an animal. But what exhibit animals do we already have? I don't know, let's find out. We go into zoo, animals. This gives us every single animal we have in the zoo. And it's sorted according to species, which is great if you want to go through and count this one and this one and this one and this one. To make it easier, go to habitats or exhibits, and it will tell you what species is in each habitat if you've created it properly. Now, being as this is Frontier and they're doing a training, they've already labeled every habitat correctly. So these are the species in each habitat. That's good. We don't have to go through every animal, we can just see right here. Same thing with the exhibits. We have 4 exhibits. This exhibit, we just put a Gila monster in. So let's go ahead, and I clicked on the words. It came up this so I can edit it. I'm gonna put Gila monster, and then I'm gonna press enter, and it'll save it for me. So it looks like we have a lesser Antillean iguana, a giant burrowing cockroach, Gila monster, and an empty exhibit. Let's fill that empty exhibit. Now I think if I click on this, it'll take me to the exhibit. Of course, it doesn't help if I can't see the exhibit. It's the biggest problem with that. So there it is, that's highlighted. So the lesser Antillean iguana is right next to our Gila monster. Makes sense, they're both lizards. So that means that if we go down here, this one should have, what was it? The giant burrowing cockroach. So let's keep it in the same thing and find something similar to the giant burrowing cockroach to put in here. Now we could go over here to exhibit trading, pull up the list. We can also go over here to view exhibit animal market. So we're just going to click on that, and there it is. We're in the animal market for exhibits. We need to find something that matches the giant burrowing cockroach. So there's the giant burrowing cockroach. I'm not a big fan of cockroaches. There's a giant tiger land snail. That's suitably insectivorous or whatever it is. Gila monster? No. We already have a Gila monster. Oh, there's a lot of Goliath frog. Cool. But yeah, and then the lesser Antillean iguanas. You know, we're already at the bottom. Let's go for the one that's like the insect, which is the snail. Alright, and then we're just gonna grab what they call a female and one they call a male. You notice one was for money and the other one is for credits, conservation credits. The one that's for money has this little thing. Since it's being adopted for cash, it is not able to be released back to the wild, if you were thinking about that. So, the one with credits, you can release to the wild. So we're going to go over here to the storage. Select everything in storage, which is just these two. Send to zoo, throw them right there. Voila, we got it. Now, that menu pops back up, so we X out of here. Going to get closer here, and we're just going to repeat the steps Nancy taught us. Go over here to layout, give them some rock piles to go around with. So there's that thing, look at them. I'll zoom in later. Go over here to climate. See over here, animal is not in its ideal humidity range. And they need to be in 23 to 36, so let's bring that down some. There we go. And this one needs a humidity of 40 to 60 degrees. It has nothing right now, so let's go to 40 to 60 degrees. Okay. And then let's work on the windows. Let's separate these two. What window? It's not that one. Is it this one? Yep, it's window number two. Make sure you press OK on those or it won't take. So there we go. We got the exhibits in. I'm going to go down. Oh, look at this. I think. Look at it. Her, it. Let's say call it an it. Snails are interesting. That's a big snail. Okay, we're getting out of there. Slugfest, not happening. So now that we've got that exhibit, that's a new animal in. We had 9, now we have 10 species in the zoo, so we just need to pick 2 more. All right, now, just so you guys know, I will go over the zoo. We will find a place to put some habitats in, and then I will go to a fast forward mode. Because putting a habitat in this type of thing, when I want to make it quick, habitats aren't necessarily quick to put in. They're fun to put in, but I will definitely do like a fast forward and some quick action stuff. So this is the zoo right now. Let's find our zoo border. This is the entrance. Now, every one of these zoos has there it is. See that white line? That white dotted line? That is the zoo border, which means you can place and create and build and do anything inside of this border. Let's go up. See, there's a corner. The other corner's over here, and it goes over this way. So that's actually pretty good. I mean, so if I wanted to, I could build out here. I could build on these little our deltas. There went my mind. I could build over here if I wanted. But let's keep it central to where we are. All right, so we can do, let's see, there's this area right here. It looks like the game kind of wants us to do something here. They've already started some paths and stuff for us. And there's this area right here. You know, I kind of like this area, so if I could find another ape or orangutan or something like that, and just put everything on this island, because I think they don't really like to swim, so if I could just encapsulate, ooh, that would be so fun. Oh, yes, 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 that sounds like a great idea. All right, so we'll see if we can do that. Let's find out. And then this one looks like a nice space, too. Let's go over to Animal Market and see. Now, let's go to Zoo first and see what habitats we have. We have a ring-tailed lemur, a red-ruffed lemur, and a mandrill. Okay, so we have those. We have a hippopotamus, a Bornean orangutan, and a bonobo. So I don't want any of these species. I want two new species. Okay, so let's go into animal trading. Ooh, we have Western chimpanzees right there. Oh, that would be so cool if I could put the chimpanzees on this island. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Okay, we're going for that one. We're going for that one. Okay, let's, 341. Let's go here. I'm gonna adopt her just because of that. Now let's go over here too. And these are so. Let's find out some information about these guys. So we're coming over here to Zoopedia. This Zoopedia option here will only show up if I haven't bought the animal. If I have, it's not available. Okay, so these guys are critically endangered. We will go over this screen later, but right now I want to find out 780. It doesn't do any swimming, does need a large climbing. Okay, let's see. We have 10 males up to 10 females. So we could have multiple males and multiple females in a group. We want at least 5. They live to 51 years. Okay, we can handle that. All right, so now that I found out what I wanted to look for, I'm gonna go back. If you press X, you'll have to repeat the search. If you go back, it takes you right where you left off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I already have a female, so let's go ahead and grab a male. Ooh, look at those right there. What does this male look like? He's a little bit better. Or this one. Oh, he's really good. Look how high that is. I don't think I'm going to go with this one right here. Okay, so we'll adopt that one. Now let's do a female. Now I have one female, one male. Let's go ahead and just... Oh, she's good. So I'm looking at the green stuff right now. Most green is better. And let's grab. So these are my conservation credits. I'm watching my conservation credits about what they're doing. And that's not the best, but I'll go ahead and grab her as well. So now if I go to my animal storage, I have 3 females and 1 male. I think we can handle that. Okay, so now back to animal market. Now I want a second animal. And let's see. Oh, we have the bonobos. We have bonobos already. We have hippopotamus already. We have mandrills already. We had red-ruffed lemurs already, ring-tailed lemurs already, and I just bought some western chimpanzees. So, I think I'm good there. Looks like the only thing I have left is a Baird's tapir. Let's see, what do we know about the Baird's tapir? Over here, 430. He does like water, so this is good. We're on islands. I could have a group of 1. That's all right. They live to 24 years old. Okay. So if I go back, this guy, I don't think he's there anymore. Oh, he's there. 24, just under 6 years old here. Alright, I'm going to grab him. So I don't have any space for him now, but now I know habitats I'm going to be building. I'm going to be building a habitat for a bear's tapir, and I'm going to be building a habitat for a western chimpanzee. I'm going to start with the western chimpanzee. So if you guys, and as one of the YouTubers I like to watch says, from It's Good Times with Scarf with Hermitcraft, let's get ready for super fast build mode. Cross my fingers that I hope I can do this correctly. So let's get going, guys.
I am looking at what I've done. And right now, I'm choosing a barrier, and I'm just going to walk you through. And then I decide, no, I don't want the barrier. I'm going to get rid of the trees first so I can actually see the island and what I'm looking at. Then I decide where I'm going to start the barrier. I choose the glass panels, and I try to do the barrier all along the perimeter of this island, getting a little bit of the water. Mainly getting the full perimeter, though, because this is just going to be so cool. I love it. And then I come into a little bit of a problem here. The barrier is just not connecting. No matter what I try to do, it's not connecting. I back up, I go forward, I back up, I go forward. So eventually I decide, well, let me delete this little bit here, make it a curve, and then throw it out. And it connects. Not exactly pretty, but it connects. So I'm happy. I'm letting it go. I put in the gate so I can see the size I have, and I'm comparing the sizes of what I have with what I need, and I'm good on all fronts. So now I need to make it tall enough for them, because they require 16 and a half feet or something like that. So that's a high barrier. And I make sure again that the lowest one is the correct height, so that makes sure everything is the correct height. Then I connect a staff path, and I say, okay, this is where it's going to come from, and it's going to just span that bridge. I make sure my path is correct, and here we go. There we go, and it connects just right. And I think for a while here I debate, should I try to move this door, make it up a little bit? And then I figure, no, it'll work. It's registered as a door. They can get in and out. I'm not going to worry about it. So I go in. I put in my feeding trays. I put in my waters. And I just start fixing up the habitat. So this is a shelter. I think this is one of the new shelters with the aquatic pack, but it just fits so well in here. So I like it a lot. Then this is a shelter that I built and made into a blueprint so I could use again and again. Just works for these larger animals, climbing requirements and a shelter. Put in the, what are these? The enrichments. So the food enrichments and the toy enrichments. And I'm basically just putting in things that I think they'll like, and I hope that I put in enough. Not exactly certain if it's right or not, but yeah, I hope. And then I start putting in the foliage and the plants and things like that. And just as a reminder, if you guys are enjoying this, please leave a like. And if you're really liking it or want me to do more, please subscribe and follow for notifications of when I post new videos. Like I said before, I am going to try to do this as frequently as possible. We will see how that turns out. Right now, this looks like it is going to go. I am going to try to post this 24 hours from the last time I did it. So we will see how that goes. But again, leave a like, a comment. A comment would be greatly appreciated. Not only does YouTube appreciate the comments and actually grades it somehow, but I appreciate them because that means I know that you guys are actually invested in what I'm doing, and that is just so nice to know. And so getting back to what I'm doing here, I'm just finishing up the foliage. I'm putting up a little stuff around the feeding trays, making sure that they have enough height for climbing, that the right plants and stuff are around the perimeter, around the border. just working on stuff. And then I come over here, I put this tree,
All
and we
right.
end.
Now that I've finished that habitat, well, almost finished, let's put the animals in there and see what they think about it. So coming over here to animal trading again, animal storage, let's just grab all my chimpanzees and send them directly to the zoo. Now it'll take a little while for them to get here, but I think they're gonna like this. I love the idea of them just being on an island like this. So that'll be just so amazing. Now, something I want everyone to consider, ooh, that's a nice area too. Oh, distraction. Something I want everyone to consider. As I've been going through this game, or this program, I've noticed that I can actually come back to these scenarios and use them as in my own zoos or continue working in them. And I think that's fascinating because I would love to come back. And if you guys would like it, let me know and we can see if coming back and actually using these as, say, a career mode, not career mode, we're in career mode. What's it called? Anyway, a business mode. If we wanted to actually go in and work on that, that would be cool. Oh, this is why it's not working. I forgot to press play. So let me know if that's something you would find interesting. Okay? And something else, we actually need a viewing area for the people. Let's see. You know, I think right here would probably be the best viewing area. I can connect the path and it'll just come out right there. Ooh, that would be so fun. Okay, let's see what I can do. Go over here to path. Oh no, before the path starts, let's see what these chimps think about this. I mean, they could hate it. In that case, I'll just be redoing everything. All right, let's see what you think, guys. Hello, chimpanzee. Oh, you're injured. Well, we're going to call a vet for you. So you're not going to be moving. Oh, you're so small. How about you? Okay, you're okay. All right, so all along that looks green. Ah, so that's why I go through each one of these, because it tells me things that I don't see on the fronts on the overview screen. Needs more long short grass. Well, this is okay, and needs less sand, but I can I could definitely put in a lot more soil. So first off, let's put in some short grass. So come over here to terrain. Let's just do something like that. Okay, that works. Needs less sand. So let's put more soil where some sand is. Where's some sand? Right down here, probably. Now we're continuing getting rid of the sand. I can always fix the grass later. Let's get rid of more sand. Now, come back here for the grass. There we go. Okay, now that's all green. That's good. All right, so the land area is great. The climbing area is great. One thing I've learned is I don't have to put in those climbing structures. Say you like this right here. So I don't have to put in these climbing structures. The climbing structures can actually be the tall trees. So that is really great. I mean, look at this. Look at them go. I think they're happy up here. All right, and the hard shelter's good, terrain's good. Let's look at enrichment. Enrichment, I was good on the enrichment. I was good on the toys. Yes. Is one of you gonna play for me? Nope, you're not playing. You guys are just sitting around. Okay. So that's good. All right, so we'll do that. Now, let's go ahead and... Yes, I know a serious injury is there. That's why I told you to take it to the vet. Those things, serious injury discovered, those things will pop up, especially if you don't put them in quarantine first, which I didn't, because we really haven't gone over quarantine yet. Let's go ahead and get this path here. Let's do this same path. I want to make it 8 meters. And what I want to do is make it about even with this over here. So you notice that as I'm moving, the pathing is just staying with this. If I press shift right now and then move it up, the path actually goes up and to that elevation that I wanted. Now I'm going to stop pressing shift and move my mouse away. And look at that. Now let's see if I want it. I want the guest to be able to see. Oh, come here, come here. And so I can move it right there. And then right there. Here. Now let's make a little bit of a loop here. Now I'm going to increase this to 10 meters, and right here, we're just going to join it up to there. Oh, that works so smoothly. How nice. Oh, that hardly ever happens, but look at that. Doesn't that look cool? Okay, that looks good. Something else we're going to need is we go over here to facilities. Let's get some education up. We are going to put the board right there, and another board right here, and then they can probably see some things over here too. So come on, right? Ah, right there. Okay. So there's three boards. I'm just going to put this on the floor right next to them. Okay, now there's that animal talk point. I don't know, but we'll just put that right there and see what happens. I don't know. I'm not going to do it. Nope. I'm not going to do it. Okay. Let's see about putting some. Can I put some benches in here? Now let's do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, uneven placement. And then some of these guys. Now I haven't forgotten. Noticed guests love to litter. All right, we'll go closer. Let's go down a little bit with the Q, closer with the arrow. Yes, I use arrows too often. Okay, now I'm going to put up some do not feed because, you know, somebody's going to try to feed these guys and it's not going to be pretty. Just don't throw your stuff into them, okay? And we want to go over here. What am I thinking? There we go. Let's get this set up so that you guys can actually give me some a little bit more money here. Huh. All right. Now that that's sufficiently haphazard, the one thing that's stopping people from coming up here right now. Oh, here they come. Here they come. But let me check on this. Do I have... I have no power out here. So let's try to get power. And I don't think... Alright, so we're coming over here to power. Yeah, none of this is powered. So let's see about getting some power going here. I could do this one, but that's just kind of small. But if I do a transformer over here, oh, that gets everything. So let's come over here. Where am I? I just lost myself. Come on. There it is. Come down. There's that. Let me check and see. Okay, that power is good. And my water. Don't you worry about it, but it's good because I don't care about water. Now let's go down and get these things set up. Now I know we're in career mode and time is of the essence when you're doing this. But I've also noticed that it helps me when I'm doing something like this to actually continue and work on it as if I need to satisfy the customer as well as the game. When I do it that way, things end up a whole lot happier. Because I could just go in and throw everything in and who cares what happens. Like I've seen some others do. And that's a perfectly fine way to play it if you just want to get through it. But if you want to actually learn about the game, you guys got great views over there, but it's kind of hot. If you want to actually learn about the game and figure out how things work, go ahead and experiment with how things are doing. Now, we have a really good habitat for these chimpanzees. I think we have a really good viewing area for these chimpanzees. And so we are going to leave them be for now. Let's see, I think we've got it good, and now I'm going to go back into time-lapse. Okay, I've used fast-forward, super-fast build mode, and time-lapse. Let me know which one you guys would like me to use to describe going fast, and I will write it down and remember what I am doing.
The next one, where I'm getting the Baird's tape here in, I quickly look to see if I can get a female Baird's tapir. I can. I grabbed her. And then I'm typing in what I need to know, debating about that site and that site. I eventually decide this site because I have more access to the water and they require access to water. And this area right here, it's like it works pretty well. It's close to everything and it has access to water. So this is where I'm going to just throw up, almost literally, a little barrier. See, the Baird's tapir don't need a whole lot of land space or a whole lot of water space. So it can be a relatively small. And now I'm looking at the requirements they need. And I have more than enough requirements, land and water. So that's good. Now I'm just double checking the height and I need to fix this up. So I just grabbed that one panel and I raised that up. And everything else looks pretty good. So now I can actually, what am I doing here? It looks like I'm just putting in food, water, shelter, and the toys and stuff. Now, I'm not putting any water because they will be able to drink the water of the rivers and lakes around them, because it has a filter system touching it, so it'll work. And then I'm trying to get this little, this is a South American habitat shelter. And as I put it in, one of the cool things about putting in those shelter things is they can adjust the terrain for you. It's nice when you don't have that ability in the game. And I put that down, then decide, no, I don't want that there. It'll probably block the water access. So I find another place to put it. And that works pretty well. I put a rubber ducky in there, put a scratching post or a rub pad, some other things. The ball rolls down into the water just like it was supposed to. And then I put in the staff path first because I'm thinking maybe I'll do a regular path, but I'll make it go over the top of my... I'm thinking, how am I going to do an elevation here thing? So I do that trick that I showed you before. And then I need to get the path kind of in line with the habitat barrier, but also still reaching that other path. And I don't want it connecting there, so this time, instead of doing a loop, I connect it first, and then I just loop it just around the barrier so that everything works. And it's not working there. Eventually I decide, nah, never mind, we'll just do this. Ah, there we go. It works. Now I put in the media, the video devices, the benches. And like I said before, I find this really helpful in all zoos that I do now. After watching several YouTube videos on the best way to make zoos and make people happy or guests happy in this program, is to give them plenty of places to rest, put a whole lot of garbage bins down, and then make sure the donation buckets are around. That makes everybody happy, supposedly. I also, as I'm going through this pass, I realize as I'm ending the video that I did not put audio in education. But that's not too bad because truthfully, I just needed to do the habitat. I didn't need to do a lot of other stuff. And this one, I try to do the whole circle thing that I did with the chimpanzee feeding thing, and it just didn't work. So I said, no, never mind. I'll go on to something else. I got rid of the African kapok tree, and I put in some South American fauna and flora. Flora, not fauna. And here we go. Here's some stuff that I just decide, oh, well, I'll just put this in there. And since these, I would call them like aloe vera plants, okay, a little background on those things, they hurt. I don't like them that much because they hurt, but they do serve a purpose. So I, instead of doing all that, I make a little walkway for the tapirs to get through. Just a tiny little border, and I put some trees in there. That looks nice. And here we go. Oh, nope. I messed up. Now we're trying all that, making sure the water is good. I didn't have power on here, so I'm making sure I have the power. So this is just a speed run of everything that I did over at the chimpanzees. There we go.
Let's get our... two tapirs in here and see how they like it. Alright. Now, while that's happening and I have all this set up, let's go ahead and... Nope, we don't have those yet. Okay. So we can only set these up once we have the animal in the enclosure. Oh, what else? I was thinking something else. What was it? I'm going out of my mind. Stop for a second. Breathe. Wait. It's not coming back. Alright, the vet's getting to him now that I took her off. I don't know why that's way over there, but let's move it right here. good. This is good. I'm not going to worry about any other setup right now. All right, here they come. Thinking. Ball fell in the water over there. Rubber ducky is over there. Alright, let's see and wait, and here we are. What does Mr. Baird's tape ears?
My, you
hello,
have been
Nancy!
Busy, splendid!
Oh, thank
but
you,
now
Nancy.
Now that you've adopted all these lovely new species, we need to make sure they're nice and
okay.
The average welfare across the zoo, nice and high, shall we?
I think that's
and
the last
me,
one.
I mean you.
Oh, thank
Go
you,
on,
Nancy.
Get to it.
Okay, I'll get to it. I'm having fun. I like this job. He needs more short grass. Okay, so let's put some more short grass in here. Let's not make it 11, that's too big for this space. So if I put, I love the color of the short grass here. And look, they can, yes, they can go right down to the water. I am so happy with that. I'll put a little bit more soil right here. There we go, okay. Good on this. The space is just enough for two of them. That works. And the water is more than adequate. Alright, now their plant coverage. Alright, so they're happy with what I put in. They're good on all of that. Alright, that's good. So now we just need to go through each of the animals. I'm not going to do any more time lapses here. And make sure, okay, there's people coming. Yes, that's good. I still don't know what I was thinking. So let's go on with the objectives. Nancy wants us to increase our overall welfare habitat species to 90%. We're at 83, we have 7% to go. All right, now if you remember last time, I said you could come in here. You can find, but let's just click on welfare and see what we have here. The ones with the worst welfare are the bonobos. Why aren't the bonobos happy? Let's go to Tahia and see what we're looking at. Where's my bonobos? I think it's in here. Yes, this looks like my bonobos. I can't see them, but I think this is it. Oh, yep, hello, there you are. Oh, you're sleeping so well. Right, and your enrichment. You guys have no enrichment whatsoever. Okay, let's come over here to habitat and go to species and bonobo. There's bonobos right there. And let's just start with, food. Let's put a roller right here. And over here. Okay, that's nice. And let's see, a suspended forager right back here. Okay. No, he didn't like this. Now for the toys. They require a lot. Look at that, 467. So let's put that right there. Let's put a little bit of toy.
There.
Whoa, already?
You should be proud of yourself.
But I'm not done, Nancy.
Not only have you expanded the zoo and kept the animals as happy as Lanny, but you didn't bankrupt us in the process. Amazing.
Okay, no bankruptcy allowed here.
Wow! Well, you've certainly transformed the zoo. I barely recognize it. A wonderful new exhibit, some fascinating new species, and
we go.
You've done wonders for the animals' welfare.
I like to finish when
habitat.
I start, Bernie.
Who
thank you.
Love playing with a 3-foot-wide soccer ball, huh? I mean, other than professional soccer.
I was
soccer
gonna say, did you see that?
I mean, I'm sure it wasn't
easy. Standing in midair.
I expect money was tighter than a possum's pouch.
Well, I was certainly watching it, Bernie.
The welfare of the animals doesn't make running these places a picnic. Although, it does make me feel a little less guilty about how much our gift shops charge.
Ho, 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 ho.
No, as far as I'm concerned, the only reason to run a zoo is to help animal kind. Sadly, it appears some other people have far less noble goals.
No. Okay, guys, I think that just about does it for us. We did a good job. We put in a couple new habitats. I had fun with this chimpanzee one. That was so cool to do. And then over here, oh, I am so happy that these tapirs like this and they went swimming immediately. I mean, that was just... oh, that was so nice to do. And then create this little area for them, for their feeder. And I don't know where they are right now, but that's okay. So, we had a good job. And if you have any suggestions, if you liked this, I always appreciate a like on the videos. And if you're really enjoying it, please subscribe and follow for notifications of new videos. Because yes, I am going to be putting them out. Like I said in the previous one, the Goodwin Zoo, I am going to try to get these out daily. However, that does depend on my speed, my upload speed. The first video I ever posted took 26 hours. And that was like, really? It took me 26 hours to get that in. That was, well. Anyway, that was a lot. Let's just watch these for a bit. Your comments mean a lot to me. I will try to get these out as much as possible. I do read the comments. I love what you guys say. It's so helpful, so nice. It's wonderful. So thank you very much for all your support.